This is DJ Cassidy, and you are hanging with Dropout UK all day.
Dropout UK.
I just can't do it anymore, Cassidy. It's me or the music.
I began working on my debut album, Paradise Royale, 4 years ago. Yes, 4 years ago. The story, though, really starts when I was 10 years old. When I was 9, I asked my parents for 2 turntables and a mixer for my 10th birthday. When I turned 10, DJ Cassidy was born. And I made it my mission, I made it my motto at age 10, 11, 12, 13, to be the kid that people would call on to play all music for all people all over the world. To be the DJ that would play all music for all people all over the world. That was my motto and still is my motto today. By the time I was 18, I started to live that motto. I started to DJ some of the hottest nightclubs and events of our time around the world, from America to Europe to Asia to Africa and beyond. I started DJing for people I admired as a kid, people I looked up to, people I listened to, people whose clothes I wore, whose TV shows I watched, whose books I read. I started to play for Puffy and J-Lo and Jay-Z and Beyonce and Russell Simmons and Naomi Campbell and Anna Wintour and Oprah Winfrey and eventually the President of the United States, as the first DJ to ever play a presidential inauguration, first DJ to ever rock a Democratic National Convention, first DJ to ever play at the White House. And I tell you all this because this was my journey as a DJ, no matter where I was. In America or any other continent, no matter if I was playing all hip-hop at a club in New York or all house music in Saint-Tropez, whether I was playing for young, old, black, white, rich, poor, or anyone in between, I started to view the soul music of the late 70s and early 1980s as the greatest, most universal dance music of all time. No matter where I was, the classic records of this era not only worked, they killed. They put a spirit and energy and emotion in the air like no other kind of music. So 4 years ago, I set out on a mission to bring back the greatest, most universal dance music of all time, back to the airwaves, back to nightlife, back to the dance floor. The first step in this process was I put my favorite 25 songs from that era in a playlist in iTunes. I put them in chronological order and they all fell between the years of 1978 and 1982. Some of the artists on the list were Michael Jackson, Earth, Wind & Fire, Kool & the Gang, Chic, Chaka Khan, Rufus, Diana Ross, Rick James, Tina Marie, Shalimar, etc. I said, how do I get my records to sound like these records, to feel like these records? So the second step in the process was I made a list of every musician who played on every one of those 25 records, the drummer, the bass player, the guitar player, the horn players. And what I saw after I made 25 lists was the same names repeating over and over. Became very clear that the producers and recording artists were essentially recruiting the same session musicians. It became very clear that in order to achieve my mission, I had to go back to the source. I had to get the architects, the men behind the music. So over the past 4 years, I reunited 22 of the most legendary musicians of the late 1970s and early 1980s for the first time in one room in over 30 years to recreate their definitive sound. With no samples, no covers, no interpolations. So over the past 4 years, I assembled the most eclectic, diverse roster of recording artists from my era to write and record original songs. And that list includes John Legend, Estelle, Kelly Rowland, Melanie Fiona, Chromeo, Passion Pit, Neo, CeeLo, R. Kelly, Usher, Jessie J, and Robin Thicke. Claude Kelly, who's one of the most prolific songwriters of my era, wrote 3 songs on my album. He wrote Calling All Hearts. We knew right away that the first person we had to bring this song to was Jessie J. So I ran to Claude's studio, and I meet Jessie for the first time, and she just, her persona just explodes when you walk in the room. It's Jessie's room. She says, Claude mentioned you have a song that you have in mind for me. So I play her Calling All Hearts, and she immediately says, I want to record this song. Now, cut to 6 months later, I'm driving around New York City with legendary music mogul Andre Harrell. He's a mentor of mine, and he's listening to my record driving around New York 10 times over, just trying to absorb what I've done, and says, "How come Robin Thicke's not on this record?" Next thing you know, I'm at the Bowery Hotel in New York City on the Lower East Side, and I knock on Robin's door. I said, "I gotta play this album." About four songs in, I play Calling All Hearts by Jessie J. After one verse, he hits the space bar and says, "I'm recording the song with Jesse." The next day, he flew back to LA and recorded the song. And that is Calling.